Welcome back, everybody. Stan Lane, along with the Million Dollar Man. I'd like to thank you for joining us this week. Ted and I were just discussing the obvious ring reinforcements that are going to have to be done before that big match takes place here next week. And I do mean big, for the biggest superstars in the World Wrestling Federation. And one of them, you hear his music right now, it will be Yokozuna teaming with Crush to face Mabel and Typhoon, Ted.
That will be one awesome match, and like we said, Stan Lane, they better reinforce the ring because that's a lot of beef.
That's a lot of tonnage on the hoof. What about the comments of Paul Bearer, huh? You looked a little edgy.
I don't even want to talk about it. Can you believe the garbage he was spewing?
Garbage?
Oh, please.
You looked like you were just a little bit on edge there.
There is one Undertaker, and he belongs to the Million Dollar Man. And we'll all know that for sure at SummerSlam.
When we come back, we'll have former WWF champion, the 600-pound Yokozuna. He will be in action. Wow, look at the size of him, Ted.
Unbelievable.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
I always like to keep my favorite snack handy. Need a little excitement? Step into a Slim Jim. Oh, yeah.
Jim. Jim.
He is huge.
Wow, what a tank.
And he was a huge champion, I might add, and could very well be champion again in the World Wrestling Federation.
Well, you know what baffles me a little bit is that Yokozuna is not even involved in SummerSlam yet.
You know, that is kind of curious.
They're very extremely curious, and I have to wonder if it might not be because of the fact that he's still a little scared, still a little spooked, if you will, of The Undertaker. He knows The Undertaker will be there. I guess two Undertakers even.
No.
And Yokozuna didn't even want to show up. He doesn't want to be anywhere close to The Undertaker. I think Yokozuna fears retribution because what took place at the Royal Rumble, you know, that casket match when Yokozuna had all kinds of help come down to ringside, and it took about 15 wrestlers to stuff The Undertaker in that casket. And then, of course, The Undertaker disappeared. And you can bet, Ted, that The Undertaker has not forgotten that.
Well, I can understand where Yokozuna would be scared.
Oh, big headbutt.
But remember this. It was the Million Dollar Man that brought The Undertaker to the World Wrestling Federation. I brought him back. He is now under my control again. So everybody in the World Wrestling Federation should fear The Undertaker, except yours truly.
Yeah. Maybe you should be fearing The Undertaker a little yourself, Ted.
Not a chance.
You may not realize what kind of powers you're dealing with.
Oh, you're starting to sound like Paul Bearer.
Well, hey, just think about it. You may not fully understand the powers of The Undertaker. The Undertaker's power just may transcend money.
What I fully understand is the power of money, and nothing transcends the power of money.
Yeah.
Nothing.
Well, you may be proven wrong at SummerSlam.
I haven't been proven wrong yet.
Give it a break, will you? You know, but when I think back to that scary, eerie, supernatural deal, only this belly-to-belly suplex by Yokozuna. Forget about it. It's done.
You know what was spooky? It was eerie. I was there.
Yeah.
I was commentating that match.
Yeah.
Smoke billowing out of the casket.
And he said, remember, he said, I will not rest in peace. Don't forget about that.
Yokozuna probably thinking that he was...
What's he doing? Oh, no.
He's driving home a point. That's what he's doing.
But Master Fuji is telling him to do it again.
You know, it's kind of like stuffing the money in the mouth, stuffing the glasses in the mouth. It's like delivering a serious message.
Not again. This, there's no confidence. This is unnecessary. Oh, look who's coming, Ted.
What?
Yes.
Oh, no.
Here come Mabel and Typhoon down to ringside.
Widen the aisle.
Yes, sir. They'll put a stop to this and hurry up.
Stick your nose in somebody else's business.
Check out the tonnage on your screen right now. Awesome. Awesome is the word for it. You know, Ted, we spoke about the ring being reinforced for next week's match. I don't think it's been reinforced yet. It may collapse.
That's right, Yokozuna. Go ahead and get out of the ring.
Yeah, go ahead and run.
Run.
Yeah.
Look at those two guys against one. What is he going to do? Stand there and make a fool of himself?
I wonder where Tony Crush could be. Yokozuna's partner.
That's right. You don't have to worry about it right now, Yokozuna. Just handle this next week.
Yeah. Yokozuna and Master Fuji giving plenty of leeway here to the huge tag team of Mabel and Typhoon.
Now, you notice that one didn't come by himself. They both had to come.
Well, Master Fuji's down here, too. And there's Asuka.
Oh, please. What's he doing here?
Yeah.
Yeah. Master Fuji's no idiot. He's not going to stick around for that garbage.
Yeah, you better head back to the dressing room and prepare yourself for that big matchup that's going to be here